The nation's interagency fire management professionals ignite thousands of prescribed fires each year. Between 2008 and 2014, over 33,000 prescribed fires were implemented. Less than 50 of these fires resulted in declared wildfires, and is evidence that 99.8% of the time, prescribed fires are successfully implemented, stay within the project area, and meet the burn plan objectives. As learning organizations, we are always proactive in order to learn from and continue to reduce the number of times when our experience and the plan aren't enough. We are a key part of an increased effort nationwide to increase both the number and scale of prescribed fires as a means of managing living and dead plant materials, or fuels. A heavy focus has been placed on using both broadcast burning and pile burning. Prescribed fire operators, as we've pointed out, have a very high success rate, but practitioners need to remain on top of changes in weather patterns, policy and guidance documents, and available tools and resources. Even when carefully planned, prescribed fires can still present highly dynamic situations with challenges that increase the risk of a declared wildfire or other undesired outcomes. In this video, we will address three key focus areas, including changing weather conditions, pile burning, and multi-jurisdictional fires. Let's take a closer look at some changes and new information to help ensure we continue to improve the impressive rate of successful prescribed fires. Recent reviews of individual fires indicate that rapid changes in weather patterns have created problems for some. Often, fire professionals burn in advance of approaching cold fronts in order to help manage the fire's movement and smoke dispersal. However, the arrival of a cold front can bring with it erratic winds, with winds shifting and increasing dramatically. Your holding plan and holding resources, including personnel and equipment, need to account for this predictable but challenging nature of a frontal passage. In one prescribed fire review, the frontal passage that was predicted to arrive between noon and 1 o'clock arrived as forecast, but burning progressed slower than anticipated, and at 1 o'clock, ignition and holding operations were still taking place. A slopover occurred at about 1:30 under the predicted frontal wind conditions, which quickly exceeded control and burned onto adjacent property. Reviews of other declared wildfires also illustrate the importance of adequate plans for patrol and mop-up. Fire professionals understand the importance of mop-up, but sometimes rely too much on building a plan based on previous prescribed fire plans or past experience alone. Such recollections or reports may not adequately convey struggles encountered in the past, such as when a burn was a near escape, or account for current climatological differences that could alter the outcome. It's helpful to watch for shifts in your local burn season over time and examine climatological models to evaluate potential impacts of shifts in weather patterns. Your local geographic area dispatch center or local fire weather forecaster is the most valuable tool when looking for such trends. While short-term weather forecasts may be favorable on the day of a planned burn, problems have arisen when planning did not consider the long-term forecast. The patrol and mop-up plans need to include an examination of the longer-range forecast and overall conditions in a region. Consider working with long-term fire analysts and/or fire behavior analysts to review weather and fire behavior potential. Those reviewing a declared wildfire described how the days of ignition had favorable weather conditions, but noted that the long-term forecast did not look ideal, with below-normal snowpack and warmer winter temperatures. In the past, fire officials in the area had relied on snowpack to help limit the spread of prescribed fires. Numerous other declared wildfire reviews highlight the need to look at long-term drought indicators and the potential for limited precipitation in the days following the planned start of a prescribed fire. At another declared wildfire, the site had received nearly 3 inches of rain the week before the scheduled burn. The pile burning operation lasted for 4 days, and the area received another 2 inches of rain during that time. But as ignition was completed, the weather shifted and became hot, dry, and breezy. Within 4 days of the last rain, the prescribed fire was declared a wildfire. Although there had been adequate precipitation before and during the burn, Weather conditions changed quickly after ignition was complete. This illustrates the importance of looking at the area's general dryness, as well as long-term forecasts. When planning a burn, always consider the temperature and precipitation outlook for not only the planned ignition, holding, mop-up, and patrol periods, but also look further out, up to 3 weeks or more depending on conditions. Take time to look at your area's information on the drought index. The following are some helpful tools when planning and implementing prescribed fires in a changing environment. National Weather Service Climate Prediction Center. This includes predictions related to upcoming weather trends that may be important to prescribed fire plans. U.S. Drought Monitor website. This provides information on the possible impact of any current drought on project implementation and potential duration. Wildland Fire Lessons Learned Center. This helps fire professionals learn from past incidents. While pile burning has generally been considered a safer and less complex alternative to broadcast burning, many declared wildfires in the past few years have been a result of pile burns. We will examine some of the contributing factors. While pile burning, firefighters may have multiple hotspots that sometimes need careful monitoring for weeks, if not months. Broadcast burns tend to use roads or fire lines to surround the targeted areas, and these can often be easily patrolled in vehicle or on foot. However, burn piles are more likely to be in remote areas that are difficult to reach and can be affected by sudden or unexpected weather changes. Terrain, particularly steep slopes, may hinder patrol access during mop-up and create opportunities for rollout of embers. Those supervising and planning prescribed fires should also consider surrounding vegetation when working with burn piles. Immediately adjacent vegetation is typically cleared, but burn bosses and planners need to prepare to manage ignition in surrounding vegetation. Additionally, the soil in the area may contain organic material capable of carrying the fire beyond the planned zone. Burn plans should include information gathered from expected fire behavior modeled both in and around the targeted area. Declared wildfires have resulted from a failure to account for fire potential in adjacent vegetation or from failing to consider fuel type changes near the burn piles. Helpful fire evaluation tools include, among others, Flam Map, Wildland Fire Decision Support System, Interagency Fuels Treatment Decision Support System, and Behave, which includes a useful tutorial. The pile burn strategy is sometimes chosen because the proximity to communities, private homes, or other structures makes broadcast burning less feasible. This means the potential losses associated with a declared wildfire can be just as much, if not more, detrimental. When planning a prescribed fire, be aware not only of the risk to people and property at risk that are adjacent to the planned project area, but also of possible secondary effects, such as smoke reaching roads and communities. Burn piles also tend to hold heat longer, given the nature of the large branches or logs or other heavy fuels that have been fully ignited. These may smolder for days or even weeks, which is problematic when fewer personnel are present after the first day or two. Reviews of recent declared wildfires show more than adequate numbers of personnel on the day of ignition, but those numbers rapidly fall off in subsequent days due to competing priorities, end-of-season staffing reductions, firefighter fatigue, or a burn plan that failed to include a contingency plan for long-term monitoring. All burn plans should carefully address the minimum personnel numbers needed both during and after the ignition, as well as the ideal number and source of staffing should more be needed. Additionally, many fire management programs are comfortable enough with pile burns that they become complacent. Care should be taken to avoid this false sense of security. It's too easy to move quickly, assuming these will be simple, uncomplicated burns each time. Don't assume. When working with multiple jurisdictions, fire officials need to have the proper plans and agreements in place to ensure that questions regarding chain of command don't slow or complicate responses if additional support is needed. lessons from a declared wildfire review of a past burn pile operation illustrated how cross-boundary prescribed fires can create difficult situations when they are declared wildfires that involve both jurisdictions. During the review, firefighters felt they received mixed messages from the two jurisdictions regarding response plans at various times. Lessons learned from that declared wildfire have since helped relationships only become stronger. The National Wildfire Coordinating Group's Prescribed Fire Complexity Rating System encourages advanced consideration of not only what qualifications the involved fire official should have, but also possible risks and mitigation plans for values at risk. The key elements of a complexity analysis are prescribed fire duration. How long do you expect the fire to last, and are you planning for a longer duration burn? Resistance to containment. How do climatological factors and resource availability impact containment constraints? Smoke management. Are there wind direction constraints? Do fuel conditions support a short duration burn, or will the burn continue to smoke for an extended time? Management organization. Are all resources local and committed to the duration of the project, or will you need help? How long will your contingency resources be available? Attention to detail is key when preparing and implementing a prescribed fire. Small issues can add up and combine to create a problem that may put people and buildings at risk. Follow the HRO, or High Reliability Organization's, principles of resiliency, attention to detail, and a clear focus. This involves having the proper attitude towards unexpected conditions or failures. HROs do not always avoid failure, but instead continue to generate the main outcome of their mission despite failures. We owe it to ourselves, fellow land and fire management professionals, and the public to be vigilant in planning and implementing prescribed fires. Understanding of declared wildfire reviews helps us add to our understanding of how to best do this. Burns with changing weather or fuel conditions, pile burning, and multi-jurisdictional projects require us to use HRO principles, solid fire behavior evaluation tools, and a plan that addresses patrol, mop-up, contingency, and the possibility of conversion. Remember to evaluate changes in weather patterns, policy guidance, available tools, and resources. Proper attention to all these issues can improve the success of your prescribed fire program.